TELUS Flames Hockey. Brought to you by TELUS, the future is friendly.
Check our starting goaltenders, brought to you by Intact Insurance Company, proud to partner with the Calgary Flames. Jonas Hiller's been the workhorse for the Flames of late. Hiller making his ninth start the last 10 games. He's won four in a row, and he's 2-0-0 lifetime against the Islanders. Yaroslav Halak at the other end. He is on a tear. 17 wins is right now for the Flames. Three-game point streak for the winger, who will be on the ice to start this game. 5 points, two goals, three assists over the last three games for Glenn Kropp. Fed ahead by Hickey, the Calgary native, but it's deflected out of play at the Calgary bench as we check our keys to the game. As always, brought to you by Budweiser. Great times are waiting. Kelly.
Doesn't this make sense for the Flames? Eyes on 91. Make sure you know where John Tavares is at all times. And for the Islanders, continue your strong road play. I'll get more to that later.
Vishnovsky took a bump, knocked down by Glenn Kropp, who winds up with a puck on the boards, makes a pass across to Brody, tips it out to the neutral zone. Colborne there trying to find Monahan. Pass doesn't connect. Deposo flips it in, and both teams start a change. Flames back to the puck in their own zone. Brody bank pass off the boards to Hudler at center ice. Deflects it in. Halak out of the goal. Leaves it for Letty and then decides to play it up the far side. Hudler got it back to the line. Weidman quick shot. That was blocked. Anders Lee got his stick in the way. Strome there ahead to Lee, who has goals in back-to-back games. He tips the puck in deep. Hiller out of the goal, feeds it to Weidman. Battle down low, Nielsen and Lee deep in the Calgary zone. Weidman ties up Anders Lee, but Lee stays on the puck, works it up the boards to Boychuk with a shot. Stopped by Hiller, rebound, Lee in behind.
A battle behind the net between Lee and Weidman, and this is Lee. He's 6'3", 227 pounds, all muscle, hard on the puck. Love the battle, he gets it back to the point. Boychuk comes in there, good chance. Nielsen goes for the rebound. Here's the hit from Lee on Weidman. Looks to be okay. And as you said, Rick, no
Bort star in high school in Minnesota.
How often do you hear that now?
Not very often. Puck thrown out front, deflected wide of the goal. Boma goes to it in the corner, off the glass.
Put them as a compliment. They're not scared, and they don't sit back at all, and they usually get pretty steady goaltending, so it's a pretty good combination.
Islanders want to... Loose puck near boards, tip back towards the corner. Giordano there, behind the net to his partner Brody, up the other side to Boma, who clears the zone.
So they've taken a big step. It's all about taking ownership and accountability, and not just him being accountable to the players, but when they became accountable to each other, that's when he really felt
like Granlund before it got to Martin. And it's cleared by Boma. There's the fourth line out there for the Islanders. Martin and Clutterbuck are 1-2 in hits in the NHL. They're both on the same line of the same thing. Anything that moved in Minnesota a few years ago.
When he was taking over from Dustin Brown.
Thomas Hickey, Calgary native, feeds it ahead right onto the stick of Sadumpian. Hit the linesman, came back outside the zone, then brought it offside by Calgary.
Boy, what an exciting time for the Islanders and their fans around the league when you consider how good this start is. 25-11-1. You go back to all those great championship teams they've had in the year 83-84 when I made my debut with the New York Islanders. We went 25-10-2, lost in the cup final. So this is a remarkable start for this young, talented group.
Yeah, it's amazing when you look at that number, and then you have to compare it to the dynasty years and make the point. Mark Giordano trying to get away from Oposo. Back pass picked off by Tavares. Good anticipation there by John Tavares. Works the puck in by himself. Line mates have gone to the bench. Puck taken away by Brody behind his own net. Pressured by Strome. Gave it away to Lee with a quick shot off the boards that was blocked by Brody, and he'll bring it out himself. Tips it to the corner to Strome. Back to the line to Nielsen. Tip pass to Boychuk with a wrister. Never got it through. Blocked by Russell. Leads the league in that category. 121st block of the season for Chris Russell. Here's Strome behind the net. Out front for Nielsen. Boychuk slap shot. Again blocked by Russell. And he's able to one-hand the puck out to center ice.
That's bravery. Boychuk is one of the hardest shots by far in the National Hockey League.
Letty regains control. Lead pass to Strome. Tips the puck in and heads off the ice himself. Past the four-minute mark here in the first period in Calgary. Granlund worked it up, but gave it away to Hunt. Havanek, who dumped the puck in. Icing. Granlund tipped it in. Didn't get a piece of it, though. And they're going to call it icing on Calgary. Third one this period for the Flames.
Calgary gets their first good rush of the game. It's Monahan going to start in his own zone right here. But I like the way that he forces the defense and Hickey to come to him. And that allows Colburn a chance to get the puck to the front of the net. Excellent play right there. Letty, two good chances right here. Excellent shot. Rebound just puts it a little bit wide. And then the block from Russell off the shot of Boychuk. That takes courage.
His own blue line with control. Hamannik now gets it ahead to Martin. Clutterbuck over the line with a long wrister. Hiller tried to head that. It went over top of the net. Going to wreck that new mask he is. There's a shot. That David Jones trying to get the puck off the boards. Comes free on the near side to Russell. He'll play it to an open wing. Racing back to it is Bishnovsky for the out to center ice. Just out of the reach of David Jones. Played back in by Bailey. Flames control it. Stajan tips it back out to center. Bishnovsky turns on the boards, took a bump there, stays on the puck, and then hands it away. Joe Colborne had it. Pass to flex high, knocked down by Glancross, but he's bumped by Hickey. Glancross battles to get it back and finds Giordano in the corner, up the boards to Glancross, off the wall to Colborne. Flames get it out, and here they go. Giordano up on the rush with Monahan. Over the glass, 13:40 left in the first, still scoreless in Calgary.
This period brought to you by the bold new 2015 Toyota Camry. One bold choice leads to another.
Calgary Flames with a really efficient breakout right here. Glancross to Giordano, up to Colburn right there. He recognizes Giordano's going to join the rush, and away they go. You know, it's 1-2
to take it away as Nielsen finds Lee at center ice. He's checked. Letty's bumped. Flames wind up with control. Diaz back in his own zone. Lead pass to Byron, who tipped it. Tripped up by Bulma. Penalty coming up to the Flames. Boychuk flies into the boards. He's slow to get up. And the Islanders will get the first power play. It'll be a penalty, a tripping.
But I thought it was, that play is all set up by Anders Lee. What a nice play just inside the Flames zone. Gets it to Boychuk. Boychuk, of course, a defenseman up on the rush.
That's right. Rule. It's still a tripping call, even if you do
that's
touch
right.
The puck first.
So. And that's new this year.
Yes, so Bulma sits. It is the right call, and the Flames have to kill off an Islanders power play, which has scored four goals in their last two games. Boychuk's okay. Took him a while to get up, but he comes back out.
He doesn't normally do that, Rick, join the rush like that. Boychuk is more of a stay-at-home kind of guy. Terrific on the power play with an amazingly hard shot, but not normally is he up on the rush like that.
So there are two Flames in the penalty box. I don't know if Stajan took an unsportsmanlike penalty or not. We'll check that out in a second. There's only one minor up. There are only three
That's
Flames
right.
on the ice.
There it is. It's up on the board now.
So Stajan takes a penalty as well. For putting his hand on the puck. That's what the call is against Matt Stajan. So a 5-on-3 in a scoreless game. Oposo tried to feed it across the line. It bounces high in the air, and it's tipped towards the boards by Brody, who gets to it himself and fires it down the ice. So a good start to the penalty kill for Calgary. Boychuk back to it. Now Tavares. Out there with Strome and Nelson. Oposo and Boychuk. Here's Tavares. Back to Boychuk. Nelson's out front. Oposo with the puck. He's going to switch sides with Boychuk. Oposo passes. Strome. Back to Oposo. They aren't shooting. Here's Boychuk. Back to Oposo. Fakes. Down low to Strome. Across to Vera. Scores!
Puck movement by the Islanders. Strome, who's an excellent young player, 21 years old, just excellent movement. Oposo fakes the shot. Back to Strome, and he finds John Tavares right there. See the reaction by Bob Hartley, and he is not pleased whatsoever.
Well, you're not allowed to play the puck off the faceoff with your hand. It goes to Nielsen. Pass back to Grabowski's broken up and fired down the ice by Monahan. And that should pretty much do it as Stajan gets ready to come out of the penalty box. One last rush with the man advantage. Islanders power play. Five goals now in two games in a period. As they go offside at the Calgary blue line with 2 seconds to go in the Stajan penalty. That's head down.
$1 million. Shop at Safeway. You could be our next lucky winner right here on Sportsnet.
One pretty good one.
And it wound up in the back of the net. John Tavares with a goal.
Now I suspect with this fourth line of the Islanders out, we might see the odd hit, Rick.
That would probably
flips it in.
Englund goes back to it. Juris races to the puck behind the net. Boychuk pinches from the near point. Watched by Johnny Goodrow. Diaz trying to flip it up. Cut off on the far side by Nick Leddy. Control and wheels out. Long shot in on goal. Knocked down by Halak, who sweeps it aside. See if they'll call that a shot. If it is, it's the first one for the Flames in the game. So Calgary gets his first shot from outside the blue line, the midway mark of the first period. Hit Kishnowski. Hit Bolig, and that puck bounces outside the zone. Flip back in by Hickey. One back-to-back. World hit his own blue line. Up to Granlund, who back hands the puck in, and going to blow that down on an offside at the Islanders.
The Stars tomorrow night at Winsport. Proceeds from this unique fundraiser in celebration of their son will go to the Flames Foundation for Life, benefiting the Emerson Stajan Foundation, the NICU at the Foothills Medical Center, where Emerson was born. For more information, visit the CalgaryFlames.com. Night under the stars.
8:48 left in the first. 1-0 Islanders. Goal coming on a 5-on-3 power play. They've outshot the Flames 7-1. Calgary looking to get some energy here. Tipped it out front. A bouncer. Juris can't settle it down. Goodrow behind the net. Couldn't kick it off the boards. Nielsen gets control for the Isles, and he'll dump it down the ice. A little too hard. Icing on.
A little bit of traffic right there. You can see it actually went through the feet of DeHaan. So it was a harder save than it looked. But Halak, as you said, Rick, has been on a real roll. 17-2 in his last 19. So that's pretty good goaltending.
Faceoff win for the Flames. Brody works it down the boards. Tied up by Lee, who gets the puck himself and clears. And that will facilitate a change for the Isles. Flames try to take advantage. Colborne works it in. Joe Colborne with a wrister, and that deflects high and out of play. Sezika's got a stick in the way of that one.
Klein's going to bring it, and he has also talked about what a great season that John Tavares is having, the dangers of playing such an intelligent player like John.
Off the draw, the puck comes to Diaz, but Clutterbuck knocks it away from him. That fourth line out for the Islanders. Giordano and Brody hand it off. Diaz and Englund on the blue line for the Flames. Shot from the line, gloved by Halak, and he'll hang on to that for a whistle.
They're getting a lot of ice time right now, that fourth line, right? You don't normally see at this point, with 12 minutes gone, this fourth line getting as much ice time for the Islanders, but they like to roll their lines, and the responsibility doesn't change for this group. Go out there, bang bodies, and scare the other team. See if that works.
It is game two of a seven-game road trip for the Isles, so they want to try and keep guys fresh. The leg of Martin right back out to the neutral zone, where Rafa Diaz takes control for Calgary up to Stajan. Stajan works it in slowly with a shot. Hit Bolig in the back of the leg. Bounce to Martin. He can't clear. Englund with a shot. Hit somebody in front. Swept wide of the goal by Bolig, looking for his first goal of the season. So the Flames showing signs of life here as we approach the final 7 minutes of the first period. Bolig fires it back in. Nick Leddy to it. He gives it away to Boma. Has to wait for a teammate to tag up. Now Boma.
Grading traffic in front. And excellent opportunities right here. Puck's going to come back to Englund. He wires that. That gets David Jones in front. But the traffic, that's the important thing right there. Bolig turns around. Can't quite get it on net. But that's an energy shift. That might be something that gives him some life again going here with only 7 minutes left in the first.
Tavares beats Granlund on the faceoff. Hickey winds up with a puck. Now Bailey across to Vishnovsky. Back for Bailey, but it hit Tavares in the skate, and the Islanders have to regroup in their own zone. Byron on the forecheck. Hickey off the boards. Giordano pinches, but it got past him and out. Fire back in by Granlund. Halak will leave it behind the net for Vishnovsky. Lubomir Vishnovsky. 38-year-old in his 14th season, third with the Islanders. Worked it ahead. Here comes Tavares over the line. Broken up by Brody. Goodrow there. And got some help from Hudler. They cleared the zone. Vishnovsky, bank pass, more of a clear up. Back to the Calgary end, and the Islanders start a change as the Flames work it ahead. Juris will dump it in. Nick, long lead pass. Finds Kuhlman, who drops it off for Nelson. Nelson turns on the boards, back to the line. Hamonic shot off Gaudreau's stick, and that puck goes out of play.
Good breakout pass by Hamonic right there. Johnny Gaudreau trying to create some things, but I just thought that this Islanders defense worked really well. DeHaan to Hamonic, quick stretch pass right up to Nelson, or Kuhlman to Nelson, and then they enter the zone and try and get a shot that way. It is deflected, but good breakout by the New York Islanders. Not surprised, they have excellent defense on their back end as well.
Russell picked off that pass by Hamonic, and the Flames break out. Colborne off the boards, chipped it in. Big Joel Colborne after a bump by DeHaan. Colborne battles to get back, get the puck back, get some help. It's knocked away, and Kuhlman there to clear the zone. Dennis Weidman. His pass goes off Nelson. Thought it went to the Calgary bench, but it stays in play. Fed across to Glenn Cross. He's played his best hockey of the season the last few games, Kelly.
He's been in a foul mood most nights, which is a good thing.
Gets it to stage and back to the line. There's Englund with a wrister block. Bounces free. Another shot deflects on goal, and Halak had to be sharp to make that save. It changed direction right in front of him. Changing, so Letty has room to work it out himself. Nick Letty to center ice. Fires the puck in. Hiller can't stop it behind the net, but Derek Englund gets to it with some time and finds Granlund. His pass broken up by Boychuk, who plays it back in for the Islanders. Diaz, Englund, Bulma, Granlund with speed down the wing. Granlund turns on the boards, but he blew a tire, and it's taken away by Vishnovsky. Out to Cizikas, wires it around. Martin trying to get to it. It comes free to Clutterbuck. Cal Clutterbuck on the backhand. Hiller makes a save. Rebound. Vishnovsky's shot goes off Byron. And over the glass with four.
CP Goals for Kids is proudly sponsored by Canadian Pacific and its 2,700 railroaders based in Calgary. For every Flames goal this season, the railway will donate $250 to Kidsport and the Flames Even Strength Program. Keep scoring, Flames, and help CP build stronger kids and stronger communities.
4:19 to go here in the first period. Flames down 1-0. They have played better in the last five or 6 minutes, Kelly, after a sluggish start to the game.
At one point, they had four consecutive shots. A little bit of a pushback by the Calgary Flames.
Glenn Cross with the puck. Long wrister. Halak saw it all the way. Used the stick to steer it to the corner. Monahan's there, battling with Bailey. Monahan behind the net to Joe Colborne. Colborne, three goals, clears the zone. Mark Giordano back to it. Almost gave it away, but it goes off the stick of Oposo and out. Top line out for the... Feeds it out to Goodrow at center ice. Johnny Goodrow, the rookie of the month in the NHL for December. Works it down the wing. Pass up front, blocked by Hamonic. Goodrow battling down low. Nelson took it away. Head up, able to skate the puck to the line and feed it ahead. Out to center ice. Kuhlman got it in, but it hit the skate of Grabowski and bounced right back out again to Goodrow. Up to Juris. Back for Goodrow. Couldn't take the pass. DeHaan settles it down. Off the glass and out. Right on to the stick of Grabowski. Across for Kuhlman and his skates. Bumped by Englund down low. Russell up the boards. Boychuk pinches. Puck comes to the line. Flames get control. Might have numbers, but the pass is deflected away by Kuhlman in the neutral zone. Just over 2.5 minutes to go in the first. Nick Letty retreats behind his own net. And then plays the puck to Franz Nielsen. Up to Strom, who tipped it in. Rolls to the side of the goal, and Jonas Hiller takes no chances. Covers up for a faceoff.
The league now knows about Johnny Goodrow, and he scares players. Take a look at the Islanders' defense backing. Well off the blue line right there. Hamonic, knowing that Johnny Goodrow can do all sorts of dangerous things, and nobody wants to look bad by the rookie of the month in the National Hockey League, and that's just the reputation that Johnny Goodrow has now, that look out. And I know from a defenseman's standpoint, all the guys that I played with, nobody likes to be embarrassed by a skilled player.
Give away to Nielsen, passes the puck to Strom, but that's broken up by Weidman. It makes a nice play. Here comes Russell up to Byron. Paul Byron down the wing. Russell heads to the net, shot by Byron, grabbed by Halak. And he hangs on for a whistle.
Paul Byron does the right thing on this play. Get the puck to the net. Chris Russell leads the rush, and he goes right to the front of the net, going for a rebound. There's none there from Halak, but that's the right play by Paul Byron. Simple hockey, but that's winning hockey right there.
For a bad play.
There you go.
Another one off the faceoff that goes just wide of the goal. That Goodrow, Hudler, Juris line right back out there for Calgary, but the puck's taken away and brought to center by Clutterbuck down the wing. Clutterbuck with a slap shot. That whistle's high and out of play. So the Flames try to work the mismatch against the fourth line against the Islanders, but good work by that line to get the puck out of the zone and a faceoff in the Calgary end.
Absolutely. I've been really impressed with this fourth line. You know, you think of the Islanders and all the hitting that fourth line has provided for them, but They've been good.
Chris Russell turns in the corner and lifts the puck out to the neutral zone. Glenn Cross tried to head it. A soccer theme going on tonight. Hickey, nice play at his own line to work it up through center ice to Martin on the near side, but he steps in early. Offside Islanders, a minute 42 to go in the period.
Bob Hartley done such a wonderful job with this team, knows when to push, and right now I think he's trying to get a little bit more from his team, their energy level or something, but somebody's got to do something.
Off the draw, DeHaan works the puck in on the far side, plays it around the boards. Saposo trying to get onto it on the near side, but lost the puck, comes back to Havnik. Tipped on goal, nice stop by Hiller as Tavares got that puck with the tip right near the bottom of the circle. Hiller had to be sharp to make that save.
What an incredible save by Jonas Hiller. That is a tremendous deflection. Havnik at the point, just fires it right there, and Tavares out of the corner just gets a piece of it. What a read by Hiller to recognize that Tavares with that long reach might be able to get a stick on it.
Flames win the draw. Bomba brings out the puck up to Byron. Out front for Bomba, just out of his reach. Almost a great give and go. Tavares feeds it across to DeHaan, then gets rocked by Bomba for his efforts. DeHaan gains the red line. He gets hit by Bomba. Good. Isles dump the puck into the zone. Bank pass by Brody. Out to Bomba, across the blue line. Gave it away to Tavares. And off the stick of Boychuk, it out of play.
Lance Bomba trying to provide that spark, couple of big hits, and then DeHaan goes after Bomba. Bomba clearly trying to do something for his team. Here's Tavares. He's not happy with Paul Byron, but boy, has he been an impact for the Islanders. Tavares, as advertised, I'd say, eh, Rick?
That close to a second of the game, he scored the only goal so far in a 5-on-3.
High praise from Bob Hartley. Joe Sakic, the comparison.
The bench of the change anyway as Letty brings the puck out of his own end with a half minute to go in the period. Letty plays it behind the net. Grabowski onto it there. Weidman trying to check him. He'll work it back to the point. Kuhlman across to Boychuk. He's had a couple of chances tonight. Played the puck to the corner to Brock Nelson. Taken away by Russell, but it bounces free to Kuhlman with a shot off a stick and out of play.
This period brought to you by the bold new 2015 Toyota Camry. One bold choice leads to another.
12.7 seconds to go in the first. Face off in the Calgary zone. Nielsen on the draw against Sean Monahan. Battle for the puck in the faceoff circle. Brody steps into Anders Lee. Puck goes behind the net. Brody got it back. Leaves it in the corner for Monahan up the boards, and that should do it as the clock ticks down and the first period comes to an end.
Good for luck, warmth, and assuming a different identity. Want to get your What Happens Here Stays Here on? Book now at LasVegas.com.
John Tavares gets his 16th goal of the season. It came on a 5-on-3 at the 8-minute mark of the first period. The only goal so far in Calgary as the Flames trail the New York Islanders 1-0 through one period of play. Tell us Flames hockey on Sportsnet.
Welcome back to Calgary. 20 minutes have come and gone. The New York Islanders, thanks to a power play marker, lead the Flames by a score of 1-0. Joining us now, a man who was on the ice for that penalty kill.
I think, he's got to get in shooting lanes and kind of... work is a tight triangle out there. He can't be late, on that first goal. You can't be puck watching there. And, the good players like Tavares and like Strome there, they'll make you pay. So you just got to kind of be smart and work as a unit out there.
I think, it was unenviable, but you bounced back. What's the most important thing for the club to come back? I thought you carried some of the play in the final 10 minutes and you were assertive. Is that what you want to do, continue to assert a free penalty kill? And, of course, what a terrible position to be put into early in the game. The Islanders score with John Tavares and they lead it by a count of 1-0. Time now for a look inside the dressing room. Our Calgary Sun rookie reporter returns and tonight's Flames player is Matt Stajan.
Hi, my name is Carson Stone. Today's Calgary Sun rookie reporter here with Matt Stajan. Who is your favorite hockey player growing up?
My favorite hockey player growing up was Doug Gilmore.
What was your favorite hockey memory?
My favorite hockey memory was scoring on a penalty shot last year in Edmonton, against Edmonton.
What do you like to eat before playing a game?
Right before the game, I usually have an English muffin with butter and some strawberry jam. But earlier in the day, I do my chicken and pasta, but that's earlier in the day.
What kind of things do you like to do in the off?
And take my dog for walks, and yeah, it's nice.
If you could have one superpower, what would it be?
Ooh, I would want to be able to read people's minds.
This has been Carson Stone reporting live from the Scotiabank Saddledome as today's Calgary Sun Rookie Reporter.
Four choices of nationally televised games. Start your Saturday with Hockey Central Saturday at 6:30 Eastern. Then it's the Leafs and Jets on CBC, the Canadiens and Penguins on City, followed by the Red Wings and Canucks on CBC, and the Blues and Sharks on Sportsnet at 10 p.m. Visit sportsnet.ca/schedule for details. The Islanders lead it 1-0 over the Calgary Flames, and our Flames analyst Eric Francis stops by. A lot of great stories about these New York Islanders. Eric, one of the bad parts about the NHL is we don't see them enough.
Yeah.
This is an up-and-coming team that's making great moves in the Eastern Conference with family stories, great stories. You have another one for us.
Yeah, I think, you know, there are so many great stories in that room, like you said, and we because we don't see them enough, they're all new to us. Brock Nelson is a player whose name probably doesn't jump out to a lot of people, but I want to tell you a little bit about him because I think he's a fascinating player. He has a incredible family history. He's related to the Christian family. Dave Christian won Miracle on Ice gold in 80, grandfather Bill and Uncle Roger, and then in 56 his other great uncle won a silver medal. They are also famous because they started a hockey stick company called Christian.
Yes.
And most people growing up in Canada at some point got a Christian twig in their hand and really liked it, like I did. This kid grew up in a Willy Wonka-like existence, hanging around the factory that makes hockey sticks. Of course he's going to be in the league about halfway through, you know, the first 20 games. And he's symbolic of how so many young players are breaking through on this team this year. And incidentally, his roommate this year is Thomas Hickey, a Calgarian who went to the Edge School here in Calgary. And he says he went half a season last year without him even mentioning he was related to the Christians. So he's a very humble player. And Thomas Hickey has over 70 friends and family members here tonight watching him because it's only his second NHL game here since he was drafted in 07.
Yeah, and drafted by the LA Kings and went over the Islanders, interestingly enough. Now, in that first period, interesting play, Lance Bowman makes a great play, it seemed like, sprawling across to take the puck off a stick. He got a tripping penalty, but the rules are the rules.
This is a new rule, and, you know, there was a lot of moaning and whining and booing when they showed the replay, as we're seeing here. Lance Bouma makes contact with the puck just as he makes contact with the player. It was a new rule, Rules 57 for tripping this year, instituted. If you make a dive, and you even if you hit the puck or not, if you trip the player, even if it's incidental contact, you get a penalty. People don't like it, especially because it cost the Flames a goal, but that's the rule, and I think people just need to understand that that's the way it is moving forward.
And it was changed in the offseason. Second period action almost set to go. Let's get back now to Rick and Kelly.
A penalty for touching the puck with his hand. The Flames were down by two men, and that led to the only goal of the game so far by John Tavares. 16th of the year for Tavares. Who will take the faceoff against Monahan.
What a setup by Ryan Strom. You know, Strom's only 21 years old, and I know you've watched the Islanders recently as I have, and boy, he's a pretty impressive player.
Got so many good young players
yes.
on this team. Second period is underway. Scramble draw. The Islanders take control. Vishnovsky drops it off for Hickey. Plays it back to Vishnovsky up the Tavares, works it in. Back to Oposo. Lost the puck, slides over to Josh Bailey. Back to Oposo. Tries a shot, never got it through. Blocked by Brody. Good play by the Flames defenseman, who gives the puck to Johnny Gaudreau. Out to center ice for Gaudreau with speed. Works it over the line. Gaudreau down the wing. Poke check. Juras tips the puck behind the net. Played up the near boards. Weidman kept it onside. That shot blocked by Nielsen off his leg all the way down the ice. And Nielsen gets up after it. Leaves the puck for Anders. Leap by Nielsen. Blocked by Weidman. See why the Calgary Flames lead the league in blocks. And Chris Russell, as we mentioned earlier, leads the league in individual blocks this season. He's had a few tonight already. Juras to Weidman. Weidman drops it off. Here's Gaudreau. Gaudreau works it down low. Out front, just missed Hudler. Back to the line, off the boards. Diaz with a shot. And that goes off the mask of Halak. knocked off the helmet. That draws an immediate whistle as Yaroslav Halak took that one up high.
Lots of action so far. Good rush right here. Only a veteran play by Wisnowski right there knocks the puck away from him. And then right in front, Weidman with a good block for the Calgary Flames.
Rafa Diaz got his first point as a Flame last game, still looking for his first goal. Flames have 11 blocks so far in this hockey game, six for the Islanders.
Don't tell me that surprises you, the blocks.
No, not at all. They're number one in the league. So.
Yep.
One of the reasons why they've had the success they've had so far this season is the puck is kept on side at the line, but taken away by Hamonic, and he finds Martin at center ice, who dumps it in. Granlund goes back to it. Bumped by Clutterbuck. Cizikas checked, but Cizikas winds up with a puck, skates behind the net, tried the wraparound, cut off by Hiller. And finally, Boma able to get it up. Boma and Byron both waited for the other guy to get to that loose puck, but it's a call on Calgary.
Physical start to the second period for the Flames. Derek England's going to go after Matt Martin, the guy that's typically laying out all the body checks. Good energy shift so far. Good energy so far by the Calgary Flames.
Much better, yes. They've outblocked the Islanders 11-6. They've out-hit the Islanders 11-6, but trailed this game 1-0 on that early 5-on-3 power play goal by John Tavares. Off the draw, shot by Kuhlman is stopped by Hiller. Kuhlman just stepped right through and got that shot away. Puck kept alive on the left side by Nelson, who put it behind the net. Fired around by Wisnowski. Kuhlman had it hop off his stick. And the Flames clear, but this might be another icing call, and it is. So we'll have to do it all over again as they blow it down.
And Kuhlman helping out right there. Kuhlman just comes in right off the faceoff. I like that line, Rick. The experience of Grabowski and Kuhlman helped the youngster Brock Nelson.
Oh, in the last few seconds here for Calgary. So one more faceoff in the Flames zone.
Now this is tiring. That's a lot of work in their own zone for the staging line, so you have to find a way to conserve it, and which Matt did. After he iced it, he didn't take any steps forward, just stayed right in his spot, making sure that he's trying to get as rested as he can for this faceoff.
Wins the faceoff behind the net, but crashing through is Oposo, causing all sorts of problems. Englund trying to force the puck up the boards. Isles win the battle. Bailey back to the line. Wisnowski looking for room to shoot. Passes instead to Oposo. Turns in the corner. He's hit by Englund and a good play. Knocked him down. And Stajan comes in to get the puck. Good defensive play by Englund to body check Oposo and jar the puck free. And now the Flames gain center ice, dump it in, and finally get a change.
Which they desperately needed. Excellent play by Derek Englund on Oposo.
Giordano to Brody at the Calgary line. TJ Brody head up off the boards to Glenn Cross, just inside the zone, up to Colborne. Blocked by Hickey. They go to the corner. Puck slides free, tap back to the wall. Glenn Cross onto it. Now Joe Colborne. Colborne turns to the forehand. Gives the puck to Glenn Cross. Back to the line to Colborne with a bit of room. Colborne takes his time. Glenn Cross fakes. He'll feed it back to Brody, but missed him with the pass, and that goes all the way back to the Calgary end. Shaping up to be a promising opportunity for the Flames.
Yeah.
Winds up with nothing as Nielsen works it back in for the Islanders and gives it away to Brody. Now Giordano. Long lead pass. Glenn Cross to Colborne over the line. Monahan's out front. Puck goes behind the net. Monahan chops it to the corner. Cizikas got there first and cleared off the stick of Weidman. No icing. As the Isles. Cizikas first man back. Juris on the forecheck throws a hit. Puck played around the boards and down the ice. And it might be an icing call on the Isles. It is.
Good physical start by Derek Englund to the second period. Showed that first hit on Martin. Now how about this good body right there on Okposo, and he is one tough guy to knock off the puck. That tells you the strength of Derek Englund on that play.
Kyle Okposo, 6 feet, 216 pounds.
Yes.
So not a pushover, literally and figuratively, and the
yep.
Big Flames defenseman doing his job well. Juris has to go to the bench, something with his stick. Three hits for Englund in the game so far.
Okposo only 26 years old, and he is a say getting to the prime of his National Hockey League career. I remember the first time I watched him live, I was blown away by how physical he can be with that.
Juris takes the puck, puts it around the glass, too high, went off a stick and out of play.
I asked Josh Juris this morning about his return last game, and if there's any problem with the quickness again. He missed three games with that wrist injury, and he thought that maybe just a little bit in the first period, but he thought he adjusted well in the second and third period, and of course he had the game winner in overtime.
Out of the penalty box on a two-on-one, and he snapped it home. He said he was supposed to change. It was supposed to be Goodrow, his roommate, coming on the ice for him. I said, did he complain he didn't go to the bench? He said he might have if I didn't score. A shot by Nelson that goes high and wide. Puck all the way back to the Islanders zone. Kuhlman there off the boards to Hamonic. He'll clear. Russell retreats with control on his own end. Feeds it ahead to Byron. Tipped it in. Bulma on the forecheck. Knocked down by DeHaan in behind the Islanders' net. Byron comes in to help out. Travis Hamonic watching him. They're staging back to the line. Quick shot by Giordano, and that caught something in front. Shot off the far side is stopped by Halak as well. Giordano, sneaky little snapshot a second ago. Almost fooled Yaroslav Halak. Matt staging down low. Fan on the pass. That allows Kuhlman to take it away and clear. TJ Brody under pressure by Grabowski. Brody still being hassled. Grabowski peels off, and that gives Brody time to settle things down.
And that gave the time for the Islanders to change their defense because they needed it desperately.
Halak out of the goal. Plays it off the boards to Bailey. Nice play to Tavares, who brings it out. Who passes to Oposo over the line. Top line up for the Islanders. Oposo cuts in deep. Out front for Tavares, broken up by Giordano. And he winds up with a puck. Hard around the glass. Kept onside at the right point by Vishnovsky. David Jones trying to get the puck out, uses his glove and bats that back to the Islanders' blue line. Flames finish off a change. Lead pass misses Bailey. Icing call on the Isles. As we head downstairs, here's Roger.
Rick, we'd like to remind everyone that Safeway's featured participating product for tonight's game is Heinz Beans and Pasta.
Pretty evenly played here in the second, Rick. Not a lot of scoring chances, but I think both teams probably feel a little bit better about their game, not giving up many chances.
Isles playing a good road game with the lead. Not many breakdowns defensively. The Flames pushing, trying to get the equalizer as we approach the 7-minute mark of the second. There's a giveaway. Glencross feeds the puck to Colborne. He couldn't take the pass. Gets control in the corner. Hickey bumping with Colborne. Now Bailey off the boards and got it ahead to Oposo, who's able to, for Glencross, didn't connect. Boychuk stole. And he's able to bank it to Lee. Anders Lee over the line. Franz Nielsen behind the net to Strom. It's a long pass. Diaz recovers to knock it off a stick. They go behind the net. Strom comes in to help out and gets it free. Back to the point, but Letty had activated. Goodrow comes in to help out and then gave it away at the blue line. Strom takes a quick pass up to Cizikas. Martin joins him on the rush, but they blow it at the line. Give it away. The Flames play it down the ice. Icing's waved off. DeHaan winds up with control in his own zone and skates it out himself to center. He'll fake the dump and feed it to Cizikas instead with a shot off the wing, and that goes off a stick, off the glass, and out of play with 11:40 to go in the second period. Still 1-0 Islanders. Anders Lee of the Islanders was a multi-sport star at Adena High School in Minnesota, Kelly. He was a high school quarterback, an all-state quarterback playing football, all-state hockey player, and he played baseball in the summer just for kicks. And here's some of Anders Lee playing football.
Doesn't he look like John Elway? Running quarterback, big powerful stride. Pretty brave decision to stick with hockey, go with hockey. He was a sixth-round draft choice. But I'll tell you what, he is an excellent athlete. I love the idea that he played multiple sports, so you just don't find it very often.
He said hockey was his first love, and that's why he stuck with it, plus a chance to play hockey at Notre Dame. There's a chance out front with a shot on goal, kicked away by Hiller as Clutterbuck took that shot. And a nice stop by Jonas Hiller. Long dump in by the Flames, steered to the corner by Halak. DeHaan behind the net, cut off by David Jones. Jones threw it out front of the traffic, chipped just wide of the goal by Bullock on Anders Lee. Said that he felt, I'll look at the chance first, sorry.
Yeah, the fourth line of the Islanders, we talked about their physical play, but Cizikas here with a good heads-up play right there to Clutterbuck, and that's an excellent chance by Clutterbuck. Good save by Hiller. Finish your story about
Lee. He told me today that he felt that playing those other sports made him a better hockey player. He said being a quarterback helped with his vision. He said baseball helped him with his eye-hand coordination. And on top of all that, he kept a 3.97 GPA in high school.
Yeah, that's not bad.
That's a pretty busy kid.
And what else has he accomplished?
Well, he's playing in the NHL. That's pretty good. And he has goals in back-to-back games.
Having his best season, of course.
Weidman to the blue line. Feeds it ahead for Bulma. Broken up there by Hickey. Thomas Hickey. Former Seattle Thunderbird got it ahead. Here comes Grabowski trying to cut off the wing. Forced behind the net. Threw it out front. Blocked by Hiller. Brock Nelson onto the rebound. Worked it back to the line to Vishnovsky with a wrist shot. Blocked by Weidman. Got a leg on that. Kicked it ahead to Byron. He clears the zone. So we approach the midway mark of the second period. Still 1-0 Islanders. Hickey tipped it ahead. Brock Nelson dropped it off. Isles start a change as Hickey finds Bailey just off the bench, passing his skates. Colborne looks like he was offside, has to tag up. Oposo winds up the save, bobble the rebound, but Giordano able to tap it to the far corner. And then make a play to Glencross. Tavares fighting for the puck, taken away by Giordano. Not out of trouble yet, though. Giordano got it back. Pass deflects to the front of the goal. Weidman's there, and then gave it away. Oposo couldn't shoot the puck. Flames got it back. Glencross able to quickly. Islanders dump it back in. Mark Giordano for it. Fires it ahead. Deflected away by DeHaan. Hoover picked it up on the boards. Turns back towards the New York blue line, but flipped that puck out of play with 9:18 to go in the second period. It's still 1-0 Islanders leading Calgary. Scotiabank Saddledome. Tell us, Flames hockey on Sportsnet. Minutes, two shots, 62% in the faceoff circle tonight, Kelly.
I'd say that's pretty good. Is this a Joe Young or young Joe Sakic that we're watching? Bob Hartley seems to think so, and I just love watching this guy compete. Great vision out there, knows where to put himself to get a pass, as he did on that goal right there. But just love watching this guy. And along with,
got the hook on Juris. So the Flames generate a power play opportunity and a chance to pull even in this game with 9:11 left in the second period.
Juris draws this penalty from Nielsen simply because of determination right from the faceoff circle. He just does not stop his feet from moving. You see him right from the center ice, right there goes. And that's Frans Nielsen, one of the quicker skaters in the game. That just tells you how quick Juris is and his determination right there. He wasn't going to be denied taking that puck to the net.
Holding call on Nielsen. Flames power play goes to work. 18.9% this season. Mid-pack in the league. Goodrow in the circle with a shot. Halak able to make the save and hang on.
Good puck movement early on for the Flames on this power play. Like the guys going to the front of the net. Juris goes there. We see often Colburn or Glencross in that position. Halak in that case saw it all the way. I've been really
I've shot. Stopped by Halak. Rebound behind the net. Juris steers the puck on the other side to Johnny Goodrow. Back to the line of Russell. Russell to Goodrow. Back to the blue line of Russell. Had to take it on the backhand. Flipped it ahead to Weidman. Juris behind the net to the other side to Yuri Hudler. Flames reset. Puck for a whistle.
Dennis Weidman not turning down an opportunity to hammer the puck at the net. A little bit of traffic in front there. There's one thing you don't have to do is convince Dennis Weidman to put pucks to the net. So I love the way that he funnels everything there, and it makes it awfully difficult for Halak. Down low play, good for the Calgary Flames. But I just think that it's that shot that's so dangerous from Weidman. Good block right there from Hamonic. But boy, and we've seen he scored 10 goals this year.
Calgary, here goes TJ Brody out of his own zone. Fires the puck around. Russell trying to get there. Boychuk and Russell battle down low. Hickey comes in to help out. Free. And it's taken by Clutterbuck and cleared. ...40 seconds left in the power, but deflected out of play. Fans want a call, but it did tick off the glass.
Absolutely.
Barely. It was about 6 inches from going straight out. Faceoff will stay in the zone.
So he's going to take that position in front of the net. And if you're the Calgary Flames, you have to try and find a way to win those puck battles or add one more guy in that battle and outman him 4-3.
Spot. Yep. It's all about positioning. Faceoff win, but the puck winds up all the way down the ice. Chris Russell goes back to it. Final 20 seconds of the power play. Here goes Johnny Goodrow. Cover to Weidman. Weidman looking for a tip in front of the goal. Puck deflects high in the air in the slot. Scramble for it. Where is it? It winds up on the far corner. Nielsen's out of the top of the penalty kill. Still 1-0. New York. Nielsen. Bank pass to nobody except Weidman, who turns it back in. Now Stajan flipped it towards the goal. That goes off a stick behind the net. Bounces free. Matt Stajan on the boards. Back to the point to Giordano. Trying to feed it across, but Brandon Bolick, puck bouncing on the crease. Tapped on goal by Jones. Halak's down and covers up. And then Bolick gives Hamonic a bit of a rough shot.
Neil. Bodies to the front of the net, and here's an example of it right here. It's so difficult because you can see all the New York Islanders collapsing, but that was a good play. How about Johnny Gaudreau? He's got it going again. 35 points, Johnny Gaudreau in second place. NHL Rookie of the Month for December.
Off the draw, the puck to the top of the circle. Clutterbuck's there to flip it behind the net. Giordano goes to it on the other side. Got there ahead of Martin, but Martin stays on the puck, throws a hit, knocks it free to Clutterbuck. Back out front for Martin. Off a skate to Vishnovsky. Now Brody. Up the boards for Bulma. Hickey pinches. Bulma's tied up. Martin kept the puck onside. Oposo just off the bench gets to it down low. Islanders starting a change. Oposo leaves it for Tavares. Top line coming out. John Tavares, who has 5:32 to go. Second period. It's still 1-0 Islanders. From Scotiabank, Saddledome, Calgary.
Podcast for a chance to win big.
5:32 to go in the second period. 1-0 Islanders lead on a first period goal by John Tavares, who's out there for the Flames. Are able to clear the zone. Bailey goes back to the puck at his own line, leaves it for Boychuk, who had a couple of good chances early in this game.
Hasn't he?
Isles playing a very good road game. Not much there for Calgary in terms of second chances, in large part because Halak's been solid in goal, but his team doing a good job in front of him too.
Their road roll
behind the net. Juris threw it out front. Halak down. Puck in the crease. Now at the side of the goal, and he reaches out and covers up for a faceoff.
Actually, but once you make that decision by Halak, you've got to go. You're going to see the play at the end right here, and which Boychuk.
Crease either.
Yes.
Brock Nelson takes a pass. Turns out the center ice. Watched by Juris, the overtime hero the other night for the Flames. Grabowski now turns. Weidman with another block. He's had a few tonight.
Has he ever? Three this period.
Kuhlman to the puck. Watched by Russell. Kuhlman wins the battle. Down low for Grabowski. Back for Nelson. Missed him with a pass. Hamonic onto it though. Works it behind the net. Lost an edge. Threw it out front. Gave it away to Finn anyway. End of a shift. Heads off on a change. Inside the final 4 minutes of the second period. Nelson tipped it in. Hiller out of the goal and feed it up the boards for Lance Bulma. Bats it to center ice to Granlund. And they're going to blow that down. It was a glove pass to the neutral zone. And the whistle blows. Only goal of this game came at the 8-minute mark of the first period. Rick Ball with Kelly Rudy. Roger Millions, glad to have you with us. John Tavares.
15 for the Flames, but not a lot of quality chances other than maybe that Tavares goal.
Bulma throws a hit on Hickey. Puck played up the boards by the Islanders. Bounces free to Paul Byron. Now it's taken away by Vishnovsky, who lifts it through center ice to Strom. Works it in down the left side. Backhand shot. And then a big hit thrown by Englund on Strom, who goes hard to the boards. They both get back up again as the puck chopped across the top of the goal crease. Strom bumping with Derek Englund again. He's been physical tonight. Hiller behind the net to stop that puck. And he'll play it up the boards himself. But Hickey, good play to keep it onside. Watched by Byron. Englund pressured by Bailey. You can see why the Islanders are where they are in the standings. Yep. They are a well-disciplined hockey team. And Boychuk plays it deep. Hiller's out of the goal. Nick Leddy can't keep it onside. Rafa Diaz winds up with control. Been an evenly played game.
Sure,
the only exception was the two-man advantage the Islanders had. Weidman has to chase that puck back into his own end. Final 2 minutes of the period. Josh Bailey trying to force a turnover down low. No icing on the play. DeHaan goes back. David Jones in pursuit. Throws a hit. DeHaan plays it around to Bailey. Back to Travis Hamonic down the wings. Glenn Cross. Hickey low man back. Glenn Cross looks back for support. Goes wide. Threw it out front. Knocked away by Oposo. As he steered that behind his own goal. Colborne trying to get to Mark Giordano, the captain through center ice. Over the line, passes for Monahan, tipped away by Kuhlman up to Nelson. Final minute of play in the period. Nelson poke check by Brody. Here's a chance for Kuhlman out front, tipped back to Vishnovsky. Now passes to Hickey. To Vishnovsky looking for a shooting lane. Grabowski shot wide on the other side by Kuhlman. Kept on side by Letty. Nick Letty feeds it down low. Miss Grabowski. Giordano hard around. And that'll be an icing call on Calgary. As the whistle blows, 14 and a half seconds left in the period.
What a physical period by the Calgary Flames in particular. And Derek England, maybe the most physical game he's here. Takes away the time and space from Curtis Glencross. Takes away that chance for the Calgary Flames.
Played it behind the net to Giordano. Final 5 seconds of the period. Up the boards for Goodrow, and he'll clear it, and that'll do it. Puck goes down the ice, and the horn sounds as the whistle blows, and the second period comes to an end. An evenly played second period. The only goal goes back to the first. A 5-on-3 marker by John Tavares. That's where we stand. Islanders 1, Flames no score through 40 minutes in Calgary. Tell us Flames hockey on Sportsnet.
In Calgary, it is a winter's night indeed. The New York Islanders, by virtue of a power play marker in period number one, continue to lead 1-0 after 40 minutes of play. Former Calgary Hitman Jr., longtime National Hockey Leaguer Johnny Boychuk stops by. Your club has been very impressive tonight, but all season long, what have you noticed most about this team joining it like you did from the Boston Bruins?
The work ethic. You know, they work extremely hard, and they got some big bodies, and I mean, you know, work ethic leads into wins for us, and we have to just continue to do the same thing and just keep playing our system.
Johnny, you're a Stanley Cup champion of the past, and you're joined by Nick Letty, who also knows what it's like to win a Stanley Cup. The addition of you two on the back end, obviously it's made a major impact, but how has the fit been for you two fellas?
Well, I mean, we're partners, so, I mean, we've been playing together since we got here. We're pretty comfortable together, and I think it just calms everybody down when we're back there, just keeping it simple and just making the plays that are ahead of us.
What's important for you in the third?
Just get pucks deep, get pucks and bodies to the net, and score more goals.
All right, good to see you again.
Thanks.
Good luck. Johnny Boychuk of the New York Islanders, former of the Boston Bruins, and of course, the Calgary Hitmen. Join Katie and Matt Stajan for a night under the stars tomorrow night at Winsport. Proceeds from this unique fundraiser and the celebration of their son will go through the Flames Foundation for Life, benefiting the Emerson Stajan Foundation and the NICU at Foothills Medical Center, where Emerson was born. For more information, visit calgaryflames.com/night-under-the-stars. 1-0, Islanders lead in intermission number two. Over in Calgary, the Flames trail the New York Islanders by a 1-0 score. Well, Eric Francis, it seems very likely Michael Backlund will be on this team's roster come Wednesday after a long injury delay in him coming back this season. Yeah. That means someone has to go out of the lineup. Now, we also think Ladislav Schmid could be back for Wednesday's game against Detroit. That would mean two people have to go.
Yeah.
Where do you think this will all play out?
Well, in the case of Schmid, it's easy to send Corey Potter back down. In the case of a forward, it's a little different. Michael, you could send Granlund down, and he doesn't have to clear waivers, so that would be probably the safest bet. But the move that a lot of people are talking about now, I think quietly behind closed doors, is whether or not Brian McGrattan might get sent down. 12 games in a row, he's been a healthy scratch. 31 times this year, he has not dressed this year as a healthy scratch. Some are predicting it's the end of the tough guy era in Calgary and maybe the NHL. Tom Cestito is on waivers right now from Vancouver, and there's just really no role in some people's eyes for a guy like McGrattan. He's very popular with the fans, and by many accounts, he's popular in the dressing room. So it's a tough decision that they're going to have to make. I'm basically just giving people the heads up, though, that this could be a story that could surface as early as this weekend if he could be put on waivers that early. And if he gets put on waivers, any team in the league could claim him. If no one claims him, they pay him full salary down in the minors. It would be a very interesting scenario.
Well, Bob Hartley alluded to the fact it will be a tough decision no matter what takes place. Well, coming up tomorrow night, we've talked about it a couple of times in this telecast. Matt and Katie Stajan, we know their story. You were very close to it through the Calgary Sun, and you're touching base with for this last season. Night Under the Stars, reflecting back on the death of their son Emerson and paying tribute to him in a big evening.
Yeah, you know, Emerson died shortly after childbirth last March, and the whole community really rallied around the stages because it's just so tragic. They don't have any other children. I am happy to report, as we did earlier, that Katie Stajan's 31 weeks pregnant and feeling great. They have this fundraiser tomorrow. What's interesting is all the players on the team will be there, which I think is just so heartening. It's symbolic of the community spirit. They'll all be doing different things. Some will be serving hors d'oeuvres, some will be selling raffle tickets. Matt said today, you know, they've got an incredible work ethic in the dressing room and on the ice, but we're about to find out how hard they want to work tomorrow when they're put to the task, various tasks at the fundraiser.
If you want to find out more information, go to calgaryflames.com/nightunderthestars. And finally, on the ice tonight for the Islanders, young Travis Hamonic of St. Malo, Manitoba. A tremendous young man, not only on the ice, but off.
Yeah, he's one of the most feared defensemen in the NHL. You know, you look at him, he's missing his tooth. He's proud of that missing tooth because he plays that way. He earned that missing tooth. He lost his father when he was 10 years of age. You know, growing up on a farm, he had a massive heart attack. His son remembers when he was rushed out of the house, holding onto his hand for a final time. He would give anything, of course, to see his father, seeing him play in the NHL, seeing his dream come true. Hey, the guy's on Team Canada's radar. He's a heck of a defenseman. But he has this wonderful charity, and at this time of year, it's always worth mentioning these things. He has a handful of kids come every game who have faced similar situations, lost a parent. They seem a little lost. Maybe they just don't know how to move forward. He helps them. He says they help him as well, too. He gives them their email. They talk anytime they feel in distress. It's a beautiful story.
He is a fine young man. Rick and Kelly, you're set for the third period.
All right. Thank you, Roger. And he's a great hockey player, too, and having a solid night tonight, as are the rest of his teammates, with a 1-0 lead going into the third. But we all know what the Flames could do in third periods. Do they have a ninth come from behind win in them? They were able to do it against the Oilers the other night. As we mentioned earlier, Kelly, it's been an evenly played game except for the 5-on-3 power play goal by John Tavares in the first period.
Well, they've had some amazing comebacks against some unbelievable teams, even on the road. The Flames, you think back especially to the game on December 22nd in Los Angeles, down 3-0 against the Stanley Cup champions.
Flames dump it in. Byron gets after the puck on the near boards. Vishnovsky bumping with him, tips it behind his own net to the other side for Hickey. Pass for Bailey doesn't connect. This goes all the way down the ice. And it's an icing call on the Islanders. Scoring summary brought to you by Panago Pizza. Before, during, or after the game, get a fresh Panago.
8 minutes gone in the first period. John Tavares scored his 16th on the power play, a 5-on-3. Pretty even stats there. The hits favor Calgary, 18-10. Block shots, Calgary. But I'd say this is a very evenly played game and a really disciplined Islanders squad.
Throwing out front for Juris, tipped away, and here goes Bailey through center. Down the wing with Tavares headed to the goal. There's a shot by Bailey. Russell got in the way of that one and went wide. A post over in the far corner. Checked by Josh Juris. Weidman gets to the puck and calmly feeds it ahead to Juris. He'll bring it out. Three Flames through center. Juris tried to dump it in, fanned on that attempt. Nelson took it away, and Boychuk settles it down. Across to Nick Leddy. Lead pass to Nelson, cuts over the line, drops it off. There's a chance out front for Kulibin, and Hiller able to get the right leg out and block that pass. May have been a shot. Either way, it stayed out of the net, and the Flames turn it back the other way. Bulma carries in, trying to cut out front, knocked off a stick by Boychuk. Landcross on the puck. His centering attempt at the side of the goal. He got it back, though. Fanned on the pass, maintains control. Curtis Glencross to the line to Brody. TJ Brody over to Giordano. Traffic in front. Back to Brody. Slap shot blocked bravely by Nelson, and he felt that one. No stick, took it off the knee. Flames right back in. Pass for Giordano, deflected away. Boychuk clears. Grabowski played it ahead. Nielsen's pass to the other side. Intercepted by David Jones, who works it down the right wing. Leddy bumping Jones in the corner. Nielsen comes in to get the puck and plays it behind the net to Boychuk on the other side, and he'll clear. Looking for Anders Lee, he'll give chase. Lee gets to the puck first ahead of Rafa Diaz. Lee gave it away to Jones. Up to Stajan. Now comes free to Diaz. Hit by Hamonic as he fires it behind the net. Halak stops it there. Gahan up the boards to Lee. Can't get it out. Shot from the line. Glove by Halak. Stajan looking for a rebound that never came.
Mark this save. This could be pretty huge if the Flames are able to come back. Grabowski, nice little play right there. It's even deflected off of the stick of Russell. And how about this block by Brock Nelson? Now, I watched him go over to the Flame or the Islanders bench, talk to the trainer, and he went down the tunnel towards the dressing room. So we'll keep our eye on that.
Hamonic circles his own net, then coughed it up to Monahan at the blue line. Bouncing puck, Monahan got it back, dropped it off. Weidman with a shot, that's blocked by DeHaan. And he'll take control and bring it out himself to center ice. Calvin DeHaan flips it in, turns to the bench, Flames back to it. And here they come. Byron lost the puck in the neutral zone, has to go back to it. Now he fires it across to Weidman off the wing with a long shot. Halak makes an easy glove save, and again he hangs on for a whistle.
I'm happy to report that Brock Nelson is back on the bench, but Euro Halak has been a great story for the New York Islanders. Just so steady, and I think this is what that team needed. Nothing spectacular, just don't lose games because they are such a disciplined hockey team. And I'll tell you what, he has been a real rock star for them. Look at those numbers, 17-2-0 the last 19 starts. Excellent goals against average. And only three shutouts, Rick, in that time.
20 wins this year. Only Pekka has more in the NHL this season. And as you mentioned earlier, 17 wins his last 19 games.
Pretty good winning percentage.
That will help your numbers. Tavares trying to feed it back. Knocked away, but it winds up on the stick of a postal down low. Threw it out front for Tavares. Pass in his skates, and it comes to Hudler. Flames break out. Nice pass to Goodrow. Dump an attempt blocked by Hickey. Ahead to Tavares. Tavares all alone. Tavares right in. Stopped by Hiller. And he's able to squeeze the pads and keep it out. John Tavares on a partial break after a giveaway in the neutral zone. And Jonas Hiller makes another big stop to keep it 1-0.
Turnovers really hurt you. But when you have one of the top players in the National Hockey League on the ice, they're extra dangerous. There's a turnover. Tavares sneaks behind Giordano. What a play by Giordano. Take away that chance. But what an effort by Tavares to protect that puck, recognizing that Giordano is right behind him, and Hiller, that's two big saves to start this third period. He just needs some goals now.
Some run support at the other end of the ice. Matt Stajan tips it ahead, but out of the reach of David Jones. Stajan got it back on the far boards. And now he finds Jones. Now Bowling at center will backhand it in. Halak again out of the goal to stop it behind the net. Sweeps it around near side. Puck comes to Russell. He'll try a shot that misses. Josh Bailey to it. Golf swings that one back to the Calgary end. Bowling to it. Gave it away to Bailey. Has to wait. Two teammates caught offside. Now Johnny Boychuk, the Edmonton native. Former Calgary hitman. Plays the puck in. And then turns to the bench in a change. Bowling feeds it to Stajan. Dumps the puck in. Halak leaves it for Travis Hamonic. Over to Nick Leddy. Given away along the left side to Diaz. Rapid Diaz feeds it down low. Hamonic intercepts. Diaz trying to hold his ground. Stick slashed out of his hands and broken. Strom's going off on a slashing penalty. Flames getting a power play.
Introducing the new BF Goodrich KO2 tire. BF Goodrich. Take control.
Ryan Strom off for slashing, Kelly.
Is in the offensive zone for the Flames, and Diaz just pinched down a little bit, trying to keep the puck alive, and Strom got his stick in there, slashed the stick of Diaz, and that's why Ryan Strom will spend 2 minutes or less in the penalty box.
Juras, Hudler, Goodrow up front of the power play, Russell and Weidman on the points. Flames 0-for-1 with a man advantage. Two shots. Juras waves, so Hudler comes in to take the draw and wins it. Back to Weidman. Leaves the puck along the boards for Juras. Nice pass to Goodrow, to Weidman, across to Russell. Russell, shot, bounces through the feet of Juras on the open side. Comes to Goodrow on the near boards. Goodrow looking for someone to pass to, has to feed it back to Weidman. Weidman across to Russell. Russell, Weidman, one-timer just wide. Puck around the boards. Weidman hustles over. Will he keep it in? He does. Nice play across to Russell, but he chopped that puck, and it wound up going off the boards and outside the zone. Johnny Goodrow now tipped it in. Juras trying to get there. DeHaan checks him. And Brock Nelson back on the ice. Good to see, with some help, able to clear it down the ice. 1:15 left in the power play in a 1-0 game. Glenn Cross, three-game point streak for him. Like to keep it going. Russell. Head up, finds Glenn Cross. Down the wing, over the line with a pass to Monahan. Monahan played it to the right side. Nobody was there, and they fire it down the ice.
Islanders very aggressive on the penalty kill when they sees an opportunity.
TJ Brody gets it ahead to Joe Colborne, who cuts over the line but didn't get the puck in. Now they do. Giordano's pass deflects. Glencross will pick it up near side. Nice pass to Colborne with a shot. Never got it through. Blocked in front of the goal. And good play by DeHaan. Franz Nielsen skates it out on the penalty kill with a half minute to go in the Strome slashing call. Just about 6 minutes gone in the third. Here goes Brody. Over the line. Tipped it deep for Colborne. Colborne bump. Stays in on the forecheck. Monahan tries to get to a loose puck. Giordano pinches. Feeds it back to the line. Brody with a better roll and a slap shot. That hit a leg in front. Off the skate of Hickey to the far side. Clutterbuck over to it. Watched by Monahan. Boychuk will backhand it down the ice. And that'll do it for the power play. No shots for the Flames, who are 0 for 2 with a man advantage tonight.
Plenty of shot blocks by the New York Islanders.
Long pass by Giordano up the right side. Juris worked it in. Not deep. Cut off by Strome, who's out of the box. Yuri Hoover takes control at center. Feeds it back to Chris Russell. Another penalty coming up to the Islanders. Flames tip it in. Hiller goes to the bench. Juris onto the puck in the corner. Put it behind the net, but it's touched by Letty. Whistle blows, and Calgary will go right back to the power play. When we come back, 13:28 left in the third. Still 1-0 Islanders.
Shop at Safeway today and watch future Sportsnet telecasts. You can win an all-inclusive trip for two to a Grand Bahia Principe resort courtesy of redtag.ca. Where Canada shops for great travel deals. Shop at Safeway today and you could be our next lucky winner.
John Tavares off for high sticking, Kelly.
Right here in Yuri Hudler. Hudler's going to retreat back to his own zone, and then accidentally Tavares gets Hudler in the mouth, so he's going to spend the next 2 minutes or less in the penalty box. Interesting to see Tavares in the penalty box. So he looked like he had an ice bag on his left hand. See if we can see it.
Right, yeah, there. He's got it wrapped up. Good eye, Kelly. Keep an eye on that. Flames right back on the power play. Third of the night. They're 0 for 2. Trailing 1-0 here in the third as the Islanders do a good job to win the faceoff and work it out shorthanded. They have 6 shorthanded goals this year. Brock Nelson over the line. Back to Kuhlman at the point. And he'll just feed it back to his own blue line to Hamonic to kill off some more time. Travis Hamonic wires it down the ice. Hiller cuts it off behind the net. Leaves it there for Russell. Now Weidman. Back to Russell. He'll bring it out himself. Drop pass to Goodrow. Fires it across to Weidman. Turn, slap shot. That's blocked by DeHaan and cleared down the ice by Cizikas. Chris Russell goes back to it. Minute 15 left in this Calgary power play. Here comes Monahan. Lost the puck, got it back, but has to regroup in the neutral zone. Flipped it in for Weidman, a little too far. Halak out of the goal. Flipped it behind the net for Boychuk. He's checked out front. There's a great chance and a better stop by Halak, who stones Monahan for point-blank range. Best chance in a while for Calgary, and Halak with a great save. Russell. Long lead pass to Glencross. Didn't connect. Might be icing. It is. 45 seconds left in the power play.
You're a goaltender and you hesitate behind the net with the puck. Usually going to lead to trouble. And in this case, that's exactly what happens right here by Halak. He loses possession a little bit, and then he doesn't help his player Boychuk at all. Just sort of throws it in his feet. And good pressure by Colborne. Right on Boychuk, gets it in front to Monahan, but a better save, Rick, as you said.
19th of the night for Yaroslav Halak. 35 seconds left in the Calgary power play as they work the puck out of their own zone. Weidman gives it to Joe Colborne. 3 goals his last 3 games. Sparked the comeback with a pair in the last game against the Oilers, but this time the puck is fired around the glass. It winds up on the Islanders' bench, and we'll get a faceoff outside the New York blue line with 24 seconds left in John Tavares' penalty.
Big Joe Colborne has been such a presence in front of the net. I know on the power play often recently anyways, it's been Colborne or Curtis Glencross, that net front presence tonight. A lot of it.
Cody will fire the puck in late in the power play. Top unit back out there. Comes back to Giordano at the line with a wrister. Hit traffic in front. Boychuk will chip it up the boards.
That was just for a clever play by Kuhlman. He uses TJ Brody as a screen. Brody, of course, is in good position on this, but that's just experience right there from Kuhlman. Wow, and that's just a great pickup from Hiller. That's hard to do. That's extremely close, and that's an accurate wrister from Kuhlman. So, wow, that Hiller's now made three excellent saves in this third period.
Keeping it a one-goal game, 11:31 to go on the play by Hamidick, who feeds it up to Tavares. Out to center to Oposo. Top line out after the penalty kill for the Islanders. Oposo's pass blocked by Brody, who takes control and lets Stajan work the puck through center. Dumps it in and gives chase. Bumping with the Hahn down low. They go behind the net. Tavares comes in to clean up. Put it off a stick. Up the boards for Bailey. Now Oposo trying to clear. Can't get it out. Puck still inside the zone. Finally corralled by Oposo. And he'll dump that puck in. They're going to wave off icing. Might have been, but Hiller came out of the goal crease. Curtis Glencross. Dennis Weidman. Marcus Granlin with speed. Weidman gets the puck ahead to Granlin, but off his skate right to Martin. Matt Martin behind the net to Clutterbuck. Martin goes out front. Midway mark of the third. Brock Nelson onto the puck. Checked in a good play by Granlin. And Boma plays it to an open wing, but almost gave it away and did. Nelson steals, fed it across. Here's Grabowski with a shot, put it just wide. That chance coming off a giveaway in the Calgary zone.
Feeling the pressure just a little bit.
Russell able to flip it ahead, and Monahan lifts the stick of Vyshnovsky to allow it to clear the zone. Dump right back in by Nelson. Halak leaves it for Hickey. For Lee, doesn't get it out. Juras kept it onside to Hudler. Yuri Hudler forced to the boards. Tied up along the wall by Lee, but here comes Goodrow over the line with a shot. Save Halak. Rebound chop wide of the goal by Juras. Played back out front. Batted back into the corner. This line, a penguin. He'll shoot it into traffic. Hit Juras. Tapped away from Goodrow. Gets it back. Flames pressure. Goodrow works it to the line. Goodrow flips it down low. Yuri Lee chips it in himself. Turns on the boards. Waits for support as the Islanders finish off a change. John Tavares goes to the puck. First sustained pressure for Calgary in a while. Oposo in the corner, tripped up by Diaz. Play continues. Diaz around the boards, down the ice. And this is going to be an icing call on Calgary.
Chemistry again. Johnny Gaudreau, line mates Juras and Hudler, sets up this front. And there's a slash by Jones on Halak. I think he's going for the puck. Referees didn't see that.
DeHaan keeps the play onside in the Calgary zone. That shot blocked by Goodrow felt that, but he'll stay on the ice. John Tavares down low. The Islanders push back here. Tavares trying to cut out front with a backhand pass to Oposo. It broke up. Tavares got it back.
Just strong on the puck. John Tavares doesn't give up on him. Follows it, and the puck follows him, just like most good players. They have a knack to know where to be. Right behind the net. Good down low play. He's got his line mates out there circling in front, gets it off, and a quick wrister, and it's 2-0.
17th of the year for John Tavares.
And when good players are on, right, Rick? Puck follows them all over the place.
Third period of play, shot off the wing by Martin, doesn't connect. Now a chance for Cizikas. That's blocked, bounces back to Letty. Nick Letty dumps it behind the net. Cizikas, Martin. Now the puck comes free and it's corralled by Russell. Lead pass to Lance Boma. He had a goal last game. Will tip it in and head off himself. Giordano in his own zone with a lead pass up the left wing to Byron. Byron turns. Taps it free to Monahan. Nice move by Monahan. Works it down the wing. Threw it out front. Nobody there. Grabowski able to take it away as he finds Brock Nelson, who works it in one-on-one, trying to cut around Giordano. Nothing doing there as the Flames captain, nice play defensively, cuts him off. Joe Colborne brings the puck out of the zone. Ahead to Monahan, who works it over the line with a long dump in around on the glass. Dave, short shifts, dump it in and head off on a change. 6:23 and counting left in the third. Shots 21 apiece. Derek Englund lead pass to Islanders, more than happy to muck things up deep in the zone with a two-goal lead. Strome back to DeHaan. Down low for Strom. Lee couldn't take the pass. Comes right back to the line. Nielsen feeds the puck to Hamidick. Over to DeHaan with a slap shot. Deflects on goal. Nice pass saved by Hiller. Rebound. Lee stopped by Hiller too. Jonas Hiller with a big save off Anders Lee. And the puck's carried to safety by Johnny Gaudreau at the end of a shift. Flips the puck in and heads off on a change.
Safe to say Hiller's been spectacular in this third period. He's given up the one goal. but my, he's made six or seven sparkling saves.
Keeping him in it. Back comes Tavares for the hat trick. He fired it wide around the boards to Bulma. Here go the Flames with speed.
Rick, I know you like the play of Anders Lee, that big body, multi-sport athlete, and he uses that size extremely well right there, but what a terrific defensive play right there. But here's that other save right off Lee again, right in front, rebound comes right to him, and the quick left pad of Hiller keeps it.
Back to Monahan. Monahan, Colborne, turns on the boards, to the line of Brody, can't keep it onside. Hopped off a stick. Flames have to regroup in the neutral zone. Giordano across to Monahan. Monahan back for Giordano with room. Right in, Giordano hit the post! And then he ran over Halak and the net popped. 2-0 Islanders, but the Flames coming close right here, Kelly.
What an opportunity, Giordano. And then a huge collision by he and Hickey in front of Halak. Net off its moorings, so the whistle blows. But what an attempt by Mark Giordano.
Things open up, but almost like that overtime game winner in L.A.
Yes.
Right before Christmas when he came.
Intact Insurance Company, proud to partner with the Calgary Flames.
You look at the Islander team, Rick, does this remind you of the LA Kings, how they're kind of built? Big, heavy game, they don't get rattled, good goaltending. I've been really impressed with the physical play of this team.
Very sound on their own end of the rink. Glenn Cross feeds it back to the line. There's a shot for the point, tipped to the top of the crease. Loose puck comes to the other side. Oddly, they're one of the highest scoring teams in the league. They're goals against is not particularly great, but they look like they're a good defensive team tonight. Or it's tied up by Hamonic, and it comes outside the zone. It could be an odd man rush. Clutterbuck with Martin. Clutterbuck out front for Martin, and good job by Giordano to get down and block the pass. As it's settled down by TJ Brody. Out of his own zone, Brody skates to center ice. Long pass to Juris. Juris threw it out front. Boychuk there to intercept.
His partnership with Halak, Chad Johnson, the backup with the Islanders, have been pretty strong. Johnson had a terrific season last year with the Boston Bruins, but his numbers, Rick, aren't very good right now. We'll see if he can get back on track. Now, Jonas Hiller's been pulled with 3:34 left in this third. Nothing would surprise me anymore, the way that they have these comebacks and pulling the goaltender. I think the puck might end up, and it goes right onto his stick right here, and a quick release. We've seen that so many times. That reminds me of the first goal the Flames scored in Los Angeles. Got them back from down 3-0. Jared Stoll with the block that time, went onto the stick of Goodrow, and he buried it.
They've scored and won games with the goalie pulled and scored twice, two times already this year. Hiller's back in. Here goes Lee down the wing. Lee with a shot, Hiller makes the save. Thrower.
What a season Johnny Gaudreau has had when you really think about it. I mean, unbelievable.
3:08 left in the third period. Flames have cut the lead to 2-1 on Johnny Gaudreau's goal. Anders Lee onto it. Works the puck up the far side. The Flames were able to come back and tie this game. We'll think back to a couple of the saves Jonas Hiller made in this period.
Absolutely.
Rice gains the red line and fires the puck in. Hiller stays between the pipes. Flames go in on the attack. Puck chopped ahead by the Islanders and brought out by Aposo. Brody's pass deflected. DeHaan dumps it back in. The Islanders start a change. Hiller out of the goal, leaves it behind the net. Approaching the final 2 minutes of the third.
Good confidence shown by Jack Capuano with the fourth line of the Islanders on the ice.
And that's an icing call on Calgary as Colborne couldn't touch the puck on the far side. Let's check our crunch of the game, Brody. Puck comes back to the line. Colborne ties up Clutterbuck. And it clears the zone. He plays it back in. Islanders have to tag up. Hiller leaves it behind the net. A minute 45 around the glass. And it's cleared out off the boards by Martin. Russell goes back to it. Six skaters for Calgary. Chris Russell feeds it across to Yuri Hudler. Hudler through the neutral zone. Over the blue line. Got it out front. One-timer. Glenn Cross wide. Monahan flips the puck to Hudler in the corner. Bouncing around down low. Chipped up the boards. Monahan knocked it down. Batted back to the blue line. Flames battle to keep it in and do. Hudner gets a pass to Glenn Cross. There's a chance. Monahan stopped by Halak. Got a piece of that one. Steered it wide. Great chance there. Glenn Cross. Colborne. Hudler. Final minute of play in the third. Colborne. Nice pass to Russell. Russell with a shot. Blocked. Kuhlman got in the way of that one. Puck comes to Colborne in the corner. J. Joe Colborne back to Weidman. One-timer, and that is blocked in front of the goal by Nielsen and cleared out to center ice. 40 seconds left. Chris Russell retreats under pressure from Nelson. Now Weidman works the puck through center. Finds a bit of room. He'll flip it in. Weidman heads into the forecheck. Behind the net. Finds Goodrow's. Fans on his pass. Line cross side of the goal. Back to Colborne. Intercepted by Nelson. He's got Tavares behind everybody with the empty net and a two-goal game. But hustling back's Giordano. Only 10 seconds to go. They've got to hurry. Colborne head up. Feeds it ahead. Bolick works the puck to the right side. But Juris anticipating stepped in early. And that'll do it with a minute. Or make that a...
Great example. Sean Monahan gets a terrific chance. And Halak in good position gets his shoulder on that play right there.
Third. They might add a little more time here to the clock, Kelly, but there's only 1.4 seconds to go. So with a neutral zone faceoff,
it sense 1.4 seconds left. The Islanders in their last 43 road games will go 29-12-3. That's terrific coaching and playing.
2.1 seconds to go. They add 7/10 to the clock, and then we've got a timeout here as well.
Johnny Gaudreau, another goal. Seventh in his last six games, and it looks as though the win streak is in jeopardy right here. After rattling on.
Islanders played a very sound road game after that. The Flames tie it up on that 6-on-5 goal by Gaudreau, but it looks like that's as close as they're going to get.
I'd say this is a really strong New York Islanders team, which I must admit, as a former Islander, kind of makes me happy considering all the lean years that they...
They're going to do it over again. Seems like it was a mere formality, but we're going to have to go back and get some more time on the clock and reset and face off again. And that'll do it. New York Islanders start this seven-game road trip with two straight wins. They beat Winnipeg. They win tonight in Calgary. The Flames' win streak of four comes to an end.
They played the right way, though. It's really when both teams had their best chances, but this is a game for the Calgary Flames. Don't go into the dressing room disappointed. Put on your hard hat for next game and do it all over again. Excellent. Seven hits, three shots, and Yaroslav Halak was very steady, if not great, at the very end on the save on Sean Monahan. He finishes with 22 saves, Rick.
So John Tavares gets his 16th and 17th goals of the season. That's all the Islanders need. Goodrow's goal got them within one, but the first beat the Flames. So long from Calgary as we hand things back to the studio and Leah Hextall.